Okay, we're back with some Three Hopes. Guess I'll talk to the classmates. What's wrong, Dimitri?
You got a sec?
I implore you.
Nice day we're having.
Oh, Rodrigue. This is Felix's dad, right? Yeah. Figures.
Would it bother you?
My girl at... There she is!
Oh, that's right.
I don't say so.
Well,
let's give it a go.
Got a second?
Not good.
I guess it was mandatory to speak to everybody anyway?
Greetings. You have my thanks.
The Duke has stamped out most of the troops who invaded Fraldarius. As things stand, a clash on royal soil and eventually within the capital is inevitable. As you are the only blood kin I have, my lord, I pray we might find a way to resolve this conflict peacefully. Bah, what rubbish. He sings of conciliation, but I know a threat when I read it.
Shouldn't you take better care of a letter from your dear nephew, my lord?
He's not expecting a reply. The creature means to slay me.
Your fear of Prince Dimitri runs deeper than I thought. You shouldn't have missed your chance 4 years ago in Dusker, or 2 years ago during the suppression of the rebellion. That's twice you failed to kill him.
I remember these characters.
I've learned my lesson. A lion's cub is still a lion, and one cannot slay a lion with a clumsy scheme. It's those monstrous eyes, Cornelia. They terrify me. The boy is a vicious animal, yet he attempts to feign actual grief that we can't find common ground. The aberrance of it shakes me to my core.
I understand completely.
Every night since I killed my brother, I dream a lion is ripping out my throat.
You'll run yourself ragged if you live your days in fear of revenge. You were meant to rule Fargus, and you have the power to make it so. Your royal army is the finest in the realm, and if I may be so bold, you also have me. Put your worries to rest, my king. Sleep deeply and without fear.
I'm so utterly tired. Tired of being afraid. Tired of what I've become. All of it.
I see. And how much longer until Tullus gives the word?
I know only that something is amiss in the Imperial capital.
Curse it all! I am not waiting 1,000 years for that doddering old fool to act. Rally the Western lords and their troops, and be quick about it. Have them make ready to intercept that whelp.
As you command, Cleopulus.
According to our scouts, the enemy has positioned their troops on the capital streets.
So they can use the townsfolk as shields when we take the fight to them. But vulgar tactics.
Well, now that we know their strategy, our next move will be critical. A victory stained with the people's blood achieves nothing. We'll need to move our forces swiftly, but with caution. Dudu, has there been a reply from my uncle?
Nothing of yet.
I thought not.
Your Highness, will you truly be able to strike Rufus down when the time comes?
I will do what is required of me.
Preparations are complete, Your Highness. The people are waiting for you, Dimitri. Let's not keep them any longer.
No, we'd best not.
You're our commander, but you look like you're heading for a funeral. Could you maybe try not being so insufferable?
Apologies for my demeanor. I've more than a few things on my mind. But very well. Let's begin our final war council.
You look pale. Not keen on fighting your own blood?
Sadly, I saw this fight coming long ago.
Then what's the problem?
Now that I've brought the fight to the streets of the capital, I wonder if my actions are right. Most of the people here favor keeping the royal line of succession. That's because my father and the kings before him maintained peace inside these walls. But ever since my uncle seized power, the people have been forced to endure his licentious reign. Did you know they asked me to assume the throne before my time at the Academy? They said only a true king could undo Rufus's misrule.
So why didn't you?
Because it would have divided the kingdom, just as it's doing now. Yet had I supported my uncle's claim, it would have been open rebellion. And the only way to prevent such a rebellion is to invade the capital and kill the regent. In other words, I cannot restore my grandfather's peace without first breaking it.
In that case, there's no reason to hesitate. You know fighting is the only answer here. You just have to accept it.
My apologies. I have a bad habit of agonizing over such things. And as all of you have come this far to help me, the least I can do is make an attempt at optimism.
Defeat Rufus. Okay, so for this playthrough, when it comes to like story-driven, like heavy dialogue games, I will try my best not to talk too much. Mainly because I want to hear the dialogue and hear the story and see how it goes for myself as well. Plus, you know, when you upload it to the YouTube or whatever, you don't want to be talking. Well, that's just me. You don't want to be talking throughout the dialogue so people can be able to listen and stuff like that, you know? Keep people invested. I'm invested, so I want to see how the story goes. Oh, we got the... Oh, we got everybody this time. Well, not everybody. I think the only person not here is Annette. Can't I make them go to... Convoy. Sword. Letter shield. These are magic attacks. That's already equipped. I should not give. Yeah, your chest is here. I don't really, it doesn't look like I have that much. That's fine. I'm just checking everything out. Oh, wait. Oh, that's just for you to swap. We don't have shit yet. We just started the game. Let's just start. It's all normal mode. I just want to enjoy the playthrough. But I'm going to send people out. Can you not?
Shall we?
Sadis is a healer. Bro, she loses to everybody on the map.
Let's begin. It's time to move.
We will proceed as we must strive to perform to the best of our...
I'll do my best.
Why can't I...
I'm a little nervous about this.
Just take
him
out.
Hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
I'll do what I can.
I think there's only a few stats where I can go.
It's worth a shot.
Shall we? Begin the operation.
Where can you go, Ingrid? Where can you go? I don't...
Our orders are clear. Shall we?
Oh, she can guard.
I'll provide assistance.
Sweet.
You'll start by eliminating guards on the capital perimeter. Commence the attack. This will go faster if we split into two groups.
Alright, the dude should have that. So yeah, so far, even though I'm like only 2 hours into the game. It's fun. Like I said, this is gonna be the most story-driven like Dynasty Warriors game. So expect that if you play this for sure. Oh, he's done. Oh no. The gates are open, so that's why I can
hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
Begin the operation. Our orders are clear.
I'll do my best. We will proceed as planned. We must strive to perform to the best.
I'm honestly low key just fine using my own character. Guard him.
I'll back them up.
Let's see.
I'll do what I can. It's worth a shot.
Let's begin.
You don't have advantage over him. You don't. Okay, Dimitri just loses it. I mean, the dude just loses to everybody, so he's like, can't go here yet. So.
It's time to move. Ferdiad is large. We should divide and conquer.
Hey, aren't the front gates still closed off? We should probably open them up so we can get reinforcements in here.
Yeah? A fine idea. And if things go awry, we might need another way out.
Take this.
Captain is done.
He's about. Clearly, that did not fall far from the tree.
To think they would involve innocent people. We must end this battle as soon as we can.
Out of the way!
Guess I'll switch characters.
Keep aiming higher.
Let us crush their defenses.
Leave this to me.
Take a breath away from this moment.
Alright, silence is that.
My turn.
Leave this to me.
Sure. Can I not play as Ingrid and him at all? Or I should be able to. I just don't know how to switch characters yet. Over there, put some work in.
Is this really the best the officers of Eva can offer? Disappointing.
All right, let's see what we got. Everybody's over here.
We will proceed as planned.
No, wait. Chance.
We must strive to perform.
Begin the operation.
Hear you loud and clear.
Bro, does everybody lose?
Shall we? Let's give it a shot.
Okay.
Hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
Let's begin. It's time to move.
The dude can kill him right near you. Level up for Ash? Good.
I think I'm improving.
I do this for His Highness.
Yay, money! Oh shit! What's up, guy?
Forgive me, my lord. I see our enemy is somewhat confident. Deal with this five-pound climbing.
Worry not, Cornelia. We will save Prince Dimitri from that vile puppeteer who controls him.
Of course. Reinforcements.
Shall we? Let's give it a shot.
Wait, what's
shall
her?
We? Let's give it a shot.
Oh, well, she has that.
Not a problem.
Not like my character's gonna lose anyway. I'm trying to figure out who do I want him to.
I've got this.
I'll do what I can. It's worth a shot.
We will proceed as planned. We move now.
Hear you loud and clear.
Sylvain is at level 1, bruh. I can't switch to him? Foot.
I'll make short work of this.
Begin the operation. Our orders are clear.
Let's begin. It's time to move.
We need to take care of those soldiers before we're boxed in.
I suggest we again divide our soldiers to deal with the multiple threats, Your Highness.
In that case, fling open the gates.
Sorry, Your Highness. Stole your thunder there.
Your Highness, you're all right. Some nights we should have never let it come to this.
Do not blame yourselves. However, if you seek to make amends, lend me your strength and help me reclaim the capital.
This is just sad. Can we please hurry and get this battle over with?
I got you, Felix.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I think the best Warriors game on the Switch is probably Hyrule Warriors. Well, that's the one with the most content. It's, yeah.
Not a problem.
Oh shit.
I've got this.
I'll do what I can. You march on me.
We will proceed as planned.
Shit. The dude needs some help.
We will proceed as planned.
We must strive to perform to the best of our ability.
Hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
Let's see. So yeah, I think Hyrule Warriors probably, you'll get a lot of bang for your buck. Age of Calamity and this and Fire Emblem Warriors are cool too. But I feel like if you're just a Dynasty player in general, you'll just enjoy them. Regardless.
Begin the operation. Our orders are clear.
Bodied, sir. Get off that horse, come down and fight me with your sword.
Our orders are clear.
I'll do my best.
We're doing.
I'm a little nervous about this.
I'm going.
Okay, I'll play as it is. I have not played it yet. Oh shit, never mind. Let me switch off.
The town should be safe for the time being. Let's press on to the castle.
How do we breach the castle with the drawbridges up?
These people are hopelessly outnumbered. At least our units from the stronghold can crush them all. This could be our chance. There are controls by the castle gates that lower the drawbridges. We can do so from within the strongholds.
Your Highness, the troops that escaped the castle have taken up position in the surrounding strongholds.
That won't do. We must retake them at once and ensure the town is safe for good.
Seize all the strongholds in the castle town.
If you're here to rest, we will proceed as planned.
We must strike.
Hear you loud and clear.
Our
begin the operation. Our orders are clear.
I'll do what I can. It's worth a shot.
I'll do my best. I'm a little nervous about this.
Shall we? Let's give it a shot.
I trust Mercedes can do it. Let's see. Everybody got their objective. Yeah, guys, Nota's gonna be doing this a lot. Pausing the game and just seeing where people can go.
Hear you loud and clear. I'll make sure
we give us. Give us the honor of joining you in battle.
So you're fighting ghosts. I was about to say this.
I think I've grown.
You get a level up? If I could just. Can't get there yet. I'm gonna switch actually.
My turn.
I'm going.
I shall take the lead.
Let's begin.
I guess the dude.
It's time to move.
Hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
Do my best!
What's up, Paul? You said we're back here for now? Sweet.
I'm a little nervous about this.
Wait, there's a chest here.
I'll do my best.
Oh, get that.
Let's move.
Open the chest up, buddy.
I'll do what I can.
How was the Mario Bros. Game? For some reason, I tried to download it on my PC, but I just kept... I don't know. I haven't put the link in a browser. I extracted all the files, but nothing won't pop up. So I don't know.
It's worth a shot.
Let's take the stronghold. This area is secure. Not a moment too soon, it seems.
Say, Kendall will help me out. Yeah, I know that. I appreciate it. We gotta level up.
I'm strong. We'll see about that.
Why is Felix at?
That's the last of the strongholds. You should be much quieter around here from now on.
It should be good.
Not a problem. I've got this. Hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
Let's begin. It's time to move.
Shall we? Let's give it a shot.
I'll do what I can.
What's up, Carver? I take you guys. I have no clue.
And of course, the main entrance is blocked. We need to find another way in.
Let's take the stronghold.
What do you mean in trouble?
Well done. Now to lower the drawbridge.
Let's get that bridge down. Where are the controls?
Attack the enemy from both sides.
My turn.
You underestimated the royal wealth. Time for someone to put him in his place.
More soldiers.
The capital, corner the traitors, and strike them down.
My, this is your lucky day. I've decided that you deserve my personal attention.
Oh, okay, Cornelia. Okay.
Ah, fate. You truly are whimsical. Will today mark my
hopefully y'all are having a good night, just chilling.
This must finally come to a close.
Just playing more of this game. Nothing much. Alright, let me send,
we will proceed as planned.
Hear you loud and clear.
Let's begin. It's time to move.
I'll do my best. I'm a little nervous.
nervous about this.
Hear you loud and clear.
We're gonna send everybody.
I'll make short work of this.
Begin the operation. Our orders are clear.
Shall we? Let's give it a shot.
I'll do what I can. It's worth a shot.
Where is she? Why is that not open? I am lost for some odd reason. I'm getting fucked up as Ash right now. Alright, she's down.
Getting wrapped up in my fun again. But sadly, I must bid you farewell.
She ran away like a bitch. What the fuck?
Not a problem. I've got this.
Let's begin.
Me it's weird. Time. What?
Hear you loud and clear. I'll make short work of this.
I'll do what I can. It's worth a shot.
I'll do my best. I'm a little...
She's slippery, that one.
Yo, what the fuck? Try to hook over a car. Man, don't disrespect Mercedes like that. Look at her. Look at her. She's so adorable. Look at this character. I fucking love her. Where you going, baby? Where you going? She healed me. I was gonna switch.
My turn. I shall take the lead.
Know what y'all talking about.
Oh.
Oh. You got it, a perfect dive, real quick. You got the number for hell. Man, why aren't you just putting in darkness lust emotes in my chat for Cornelia? Mercedes looks a lot better than Cornelia.
You're the most ludicrous of accusations because of you.
And yet, they're all true. Just see how you do that for Moss. It's an attempt to seize the throne.
Stand down!
You say it was Cornelia Carr. No, but she's still not better than Mercedes. Are you talking about?
You're moving Rufus to a cell and preparing him for questioning.
Good. Thank you. I will join you shortly.
Raise your voices with me, friends. You fought hard this day, and now victory is ours.
It's gonna be hard for these completed signs, right? Paul, you know how to switch characters? So I can play as like Ingrid and Mercedes?
Gotta remember how this feels.
Oh, I feel stronger.
Bae!
Keep aiming higher.
How can I best use this power?
No, this is not my peak.
Hey, I'm getting better.
I could use this.
I'm a better man now than I was 5 minutes ago.
I think I've learned something new.
Okay. Pretty sure I was trying to do that.
Something you feel like saying?
No.
All traitors get put to the sword. It's his duty as king.
Final words.
None for you. But tell me something, boy. Does it trouble you to slay your own kin? What a surprise. I did not think you capable of sympathy, craven monster that you are.
Yes. But either way, I do what I must.
Well, to perish by your hand, it is a fate that I much deserve.
Did he slice his head off? Yeah, for some missions they have the whole class on the map, but you can...
Which leads the Lords Elador, Mateus, and Climen. We believe they, as well as many powerful Western Lords, were accomplices in the assassination of the late King. Along with the Grand Duke, they seem to have received large sums of money and supplies from the Imperial nobility. Thinking this to be recompense for the assassination in Dusker, we investigated the link further. In 1171, the mage Cornelia arranged for a certain powerful imperial family to come.
Is it really, Paul?
That's the year when my step-uncle, Lord Arendelle, brought Edelgard here in exile.
Correct. We think Lord Arendelle and his followers were behind the matter. They have deep ties to the imperial household.
As I suspected. You're a clever man, Margrave Gautier. Well done.
Thank you, Your Highness.
If we continue bringing information out of them at this pace, we'll soon have a clear picture of what transpired.
My uncle's attendants must also confess to the slaughter in Dusker. But now that things have come this far, we can't expect the Western Lords to stay silent. We need a way to keep them far from power.
Oh, there are always ways, provided you're willing to keep all your options open.
Yes, I suppose so. Let us speak more of this later. For now, spread word of what you have found to every palace and pub in the land. That should help keep the lords in check.
Is that wise, Your Highness? If we announce that Rufus was involved in the tragedy of Dusker,
I will not feed my people half-truths. They deserve to know.
I've always admired that candor, Your Highness. Yet such news is sure to create a degree of unrest in the kingdom.
So you suggest we bury the truth? Should it somehow come to light, the people's faith in me will be forever shaken. If the kingdom is ever to part ways with our bloody past, this is the path we must walk.
Fine words, though I doubt they'll appease the people of Dusker. Nor the rest of Fargus, many of whom will not be so quick to forgive.
Ha! We thought you might say as much, which is why His Highness and I have devised a solution. I will resign the title of Duke and pass it to my heir.
Spare me, Rodrigue. One person with wild ideas is already one too many.
It's not wild at all, Matthias. Someone must bear responsibility for what happened in Dusker. People will naturally seek to point the finger at His Highness, and we need him unsullied if he is to lead. Someone has to get down in the mud and bear the slings and arrows for him. Who better for such a task than me?
Rodrigue will abandon his title and work with Dudu to restore harmony between our people. I'm not asking him to take his life. Rather, he offered to spend it to set things to rights.
In that case, we've only to deal with the issue of the throne. I believe we should move forward with your coronation straight away.
I agree. My time at the Officers' Academy was a valuable experience, but I belong here now. Obviously, Felix won't be able to return either. Have him come to me later, so I can deliver the news and an apology.
I've already had a word and told him what must be done.
No need to apologize.
Yes, I have. As for you, Gustav, you'll also be staying here in the kingdom.
But I abandoned my homeland. There can be no place for me in Fargus.
I will make a place for you. I need your help. Lady Rhea will understand.
It would be my great honor, Your Highness.
Send word to the Church and the Lords. Count Galatea will be in charge of contacting the South. Now, there's another topic I'd like to discuss. I wish to reorganize my army. Since I have you all assembled, I'd like to hear your suggestions.
You still working, Dimitri? Have you even slept since the battle?
Never mind that. There's a favor I've been meaning to ask of you. It won't happen right away, but I'm considering the formation of a new private army. I need someone to captain them, and I was hoping it might be you.
And what does the leader of the kingdom need with a private army?
I fear my uncle may have rubbed off on too many of my knights. I'm not saying they're all bad, but it's clear as day that bribery ran rampant. To rectify the matter, I'm looking into a complete reorganization of the army. These next several years will be an age of civil war, and I want to be surrounded with the best and most loyal soldiers I can find.
Well, that does sound interesting. Still, I'm just a regular old grunt. Why put me in charge?
Because this will be an army of commoners, not knights and nobles. A mercenary like you is far more likely to earn their trust than some stuffy noble who's never known a day of hardship. Please, allow me to be clear. This is not an order. If you'd rather return to the academy, you're free to do so.
Are you kidding? I'm in.
Thank you, Dimitri.
Having put down Rufus's revolt and ended his uncle's life, Dimitri draws closer to the truth regarding the tragedy of Dusker, and also begins the process of ascending the throne. All the while, the Adrestian Empire deals with a fierce power struggle in its capital, Anbar, while the Lester Alliance finds themselves pitted against an invading Olmyran horde. Realizing the troubles of Fodlan will fall squarely on her young student's shoulders, Archbishop Rhea closes the Officers Academy and permits her charges to return home.
Is that it for the prologue? Seems like this story is moving. The story, like in this game, is moving faster, a lot more faster than it did with Three Houses. Azure Gleam to war.
To war. It is the end of 1181. 2 years have passed since the Officers' Academy closed its doors. After ascending the throne, Dimitri labors to bring peace to the Holy Kingdom of Fargus. With Edelgard ruling as the Emperor of Adrestia and Claude leading the Lester Alliance, the three erstwhile schoolmates strike out as the next generation of leaders. A new era is dawning in Fodlan, and much teeters at the brink of great change. The first tremors of a major upheaval rock the land as Edelgard declares war on the Central Church.
Edelgard still being Edelgard, I see.
Pardon my lateness, Your Majesty.
You needn't worry, Felix. I know your duties are many. Though, I'm afraid we could not wait for you to begin the discussion.
This is about the Empire's declaration of war against the Central Church, yes?
Indeed. As you're aware, We have already begun accepting refugees from Garrett Monk. But a few days ago, I received a confidential request from Seteth, asking us to protect the higher-ranking members of the church, including Lady Rhea herself. Of course, we'd only meet this eventuality were Garrett Monk to fall. As it stands, we find ourselves quite literally stuck between the Empire and the Church. I'm not sure how much longer we can remain neutral.
If I might, Your Majesty, troubling as it may be, I believe it prudent for us to reject this proposal from the Church outright. Offering them shelter will only serve to provoke an invasion from the Empire. This matter of the Southern Church concerns me as well, but I believe we have more important matters to be fussing over at the moment.
Your counsel is much appreciated, Viscount Elidor, but I assure you, things are not as cut and dry as you make them out to be. The mandate granted to the King of Fargus and all the lords who serve under him is given legitimacy only by the grace of the Church. Are we to renounce the very heart of this kingdom simply because we shudder at the thought of invasion? War will always come at one point or another, and some degree of suffering is purely inevitable. You know this as well as I, Viscount.
You dare speak of suffering, do you? When the blaze of war will not scorch your lands in the north as it does ours?
I would normally agree that those of us from the Northern Territory should hold less sway in this discussion. But if Garrick Mock were to fall, the war fronts would not halt in the west. Your Majesty, what of House Roe or Galatea, or the others in the south?
Not a word from Count Roe as it stands, but I did receive a missive from Count Galatea. It read, "My people are not fools enough to rejoice in the surrender of their territories to invaders. There is no morality in turning our backs on the institution at the very foundation of our lives. We must support the Church as they have supported us."
Your Majesty, we owe a great debt to the Central Church for their role in quelling the uprising 2 years ago. To not repay such generosity in kind would risk weakening the trust of your vassals.
And if that happens, we might find ourselves right back in the same mess as before. They lack the Crest of Blathid, but there's no small number of nobles who might crawl out of the woodwork claiming royal blood. The kingdom's already seen the turmoil and division such claimants can bring after the death of King Klaus.
But Duke Frontarius, surely we are better served attempting to head off the very real and imminent war at hand instead of debating hypothetical unrest.
I don't want my people to suffer the pain of conflict. But does anyone here really think the Empire will simply stop if we appease their every demand? Suppose we do let the Empire take the Archbishop. And suppose we accept this new Southern Church. Then what?
I imagine the Empire plans to install the Bishop of the Southern Church, Count Varley, in Lady Rhea's place. I fear I've heard nothing good concerning either the man himself or his teachings. They purport to be an arm of the Church of Seros, but the Southern Church is nothing more than a mouthpiece for the Empire at large.
In other words, rejecting the Central Church in favor of this new Southern one would be no different from flat-out accepting Imperial rule. It's hard to say just how they would treat our kingdom were such events to unfold. Though I imagine it would involve heavy taxation for the express purpose of bleeding Fargus dry and filling the Imperial coffers.
Do you have something to add, Duke Fraldarius?
Not really, no. I was just wondering how long we were planning to continue this tedious charade. The question's simple. Do we hand over our kingdom and subject ourselves to Imperial rule or not?
I believe the Margrave has been quite clear as to what will happen if we give in to the Empire's demands. We've all been informed of the rapid reformation their region has undergone. Many aspects of which I admire, I'm not ashamed to say. But an old, stubborn land like ours isn't suited for such tempestuous change. Radical new freedoms are not what the people of Fargus need right now. They need stability, steady improvement in their daily lives, and real, lasting change can only come from a solid foundation.
Sounds like your majesty has made up his mind then. Just say the word and we'll leap into action.
The Holy Kingdom of Fargus will hereby offer asylum to the Church of Seros. Everyone, sharpen your blades and prepare for the battles ahead. Gustav, Dudu, make to ride at once. Our intentions must be made clear. Not only to the Church and the Empire, but to Count Roe as well, and all the other lords who failed to answer my summons.
Understood, Your Majesty.
Hey, did you hear? Sounds like we're gonna be going to war with the Empire.
Yeah, I'm aware.
Ever since His Majesty ascended the throne, we've been fighting battle after battle through every corner of Fargus. But I never thought we'd be going toe-to-toe with the actual Empire. I'd be nervous if it even felt real.
Alright, so you say, hey, they got the clean hairstyles this time? Yeah. I do like their designs. So I'm trying to remember. So how many years was three houses time skip? This is two. Let me see. Paul, you probably know. I forgot. Like I said, they don't look like they got too much older. Five, yeah, so the time skip in three houses is a way bigger gap. But their designs are cool. So my thing is, whatever happened to Byleth? So it seems like we're going to war with Edelgard, which I was hoping for a different outcome, but I guess not.
Yeah, I'm not opposed to the war or anything, but I have a weird feeling about this too.
You uneasy? I didn't even think that was possible. But I suppose you learn something new every day.
I can't help but wonder though, what happens to Fargus now? I feel like things have been steadily improving lately. Not everyone favors His Majesty as I do.
Yeah, I hear the grumbles too. But there's not a ruler in the world who doesn't have their fair share of critics, right? All I know is, we wouldn't be where we are now if not for him. I mean, look at me, saddled with some mysterious power we don't know anything about. He still chose to put his faith in me. It's only right I return the favor in kind. Oh, and speak of the devil.
Am I interrupting something?
No, of course not. Please, allow me to take my leave. Your Majesty, Commander.
So, you heard all that, huh?
More or less. I apologize for the interruption, but there's an urgent matter at hand.
Anything I can do to help?
There is. As you know, we've offered asylum to the Central Church in their efforts to flee the Empire. As such, we are to escort the Archbishop herself to the Royal Capital at once. I expect heavy pursuit from the Imperial forces, so I am assembling a team of those I trust most to assist in the mission. Of course, I'll be leading my own regiment into battle, but I was wondering if you'd be willing to accompany me.
What, is that it? I'd be glad to. How are things looking at Garrick Mach while we're on the subject?
Grim. Neither the Knights of Seros nor the Monastery Ramparts Guards are capable of holding off the Empire's massive military might. I dare say we have precious little time to waste. Prepare to deploy at once.
At least Dimitri has something for you, Shaz. Claw had me go broke for 2 years. Ah, man. Yeah, so you said Byleth doesn't come back for a hot minute. Okay. So, I assume Byleth is barely in the game at all. So, okay. I mean, I guess that's fine. This our new hub? Says, without any spoilers, Byleth's pretty insignificant in this game, save for a few things. Okay. So basically, Dimitri, Claude, and Edelgard don't know who Byleth is whatsoever. Change my appearance.
That reminds me.
Tiresome.
Rodriguez now playable. Annette has rejoined. Okay, a lot of stuff changed because of the 2 year time shift. Okay. Look at her! Look at her! We got the best new design. You're looking at her. Man, oh man. All their designs are cool though. You might have to steal that car. Shut your ass up. This is my car, if you know what I mean. Oh, man. All right, Paris, just calm down. I need to calm down. It's a game, man. It's a game. Yeah, but this time, skip was, 2 year Scott. The 2 year time skip was fast as hell. Because remember when you played three, houses that you played quite a few chapters? You know, you played a lot of chapters in order to, an award is available. What is this? I don't have any renown. So you played quite a few chapters before the time skip. Where do I get my award at? Where is she? Where is she? I must know where she's at. Mercedes. Yeah, that is absolutely true. It's like, the thing is, Dimitri Cloud and Edelgard didn't run into Byleth at all, you know? It's like, it seems like, yeah, the story is pretty different. Oh, here's another wifey right here. What's up, Annette?
Heya.
You can learn a thing or two from me, huh? 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 Alright. She's not in the infirmary. Annette, where your friend at? She daydreaming. Here you go, Felix.
Yeah, I don't know.
You say what? You say there's like a map or something like that? Button. They're the same. It's the same thing. It's the same thing. If you press plus and you press minus, then the same thing happens. So yeah. Where are you? But yeah, it's crazy that the time skip happened so fast. Okay. If I can find him.
May I speak with you?
I'll find him.
I have a request.
Your daughter. Guess what, bro? She said she wanna learn a thing or two from me. You know what I mean? I'll teach her something. Hey, Jacob, thank you so much for the follow. Appreciate that. Look, is that a cat? That's a cat. Rolling in dirt. But yeah, Jacob, if you're in the chat, if you got any questions for me, feel free. I probably won't be streaming that much longer. Truthfully, to be honest with you, I'm just exploring the new main hub, and then I'm gonna end things off. Where is Dimitri and Mercedes? God damn. Where are they at? Ah! She's right here! Look at her! Look at her! Look at her! Look at her fall! The one, the only, best girl. Right here. Look at me. You better look at me. You said, Fuck. Bro, I can't take pictures? Yes. All right. You said that's hella cap. Nah. Now you got on the wrong team. If I could have an S support, it will be with her. You can help me with something, all right? That's incredibly cap. Nah. Oh, you mean this map? Okay. Who? What is he talking about? All right, here's Dimitri right here.
Over here. I've been waiting for you. How about this?
Okay, so I'm pretty much gonna end things off here. This is a small step than the other like camp for sure. Too bad it's not Garrett Mock, but it's fine. Unfortunate, Byleth isn't, it seems like Byleth isn't too much in this game, but it's whatever. It's all good, I guess. Oh, second best girl. Let me talk to her real quick.
Why, hello.
They haven't seen Shaz in 2 years. Look at her. All right. What? You talk about Marine and you talk about Hilda as a duo. Look at Mercedes, Annette, and look at Ingrid, man. Best girls in the game every day, all day. I don't know what you're talking about. But all right, let me save it. System. Didn't really do too much, but like one battle, I guess, but it's all good. I'll probably try to do a couple of more, at least like a second battle. Meanwhile, Patrick clears all of them. Well, Patrick isn't on the Golden Deer or Blue Lions, bro. Oh, okay. This is now chapter 4 to war. So this is the chapter where when someone dies, then you lose them forever. So, okay. I've gotten to that chapter. But yeah, that'll do it, chat. I'll be back for sure with some more gameplay of this. Well, it's mainly more so a narrative, like story talking, rather than gameplay. But, I mean, I'm enjoying it. Like I said, it sucks that Byleth isn't really too much into the story, but... Yeah, I have a set to permadeath. I have a set to permadeath. But I'm only playing on normal mode, though, so... It should be good. Oh, I finna clip the Mercedes Lost Frey 1? No, the fuck you're not. I will restart the fucking game. I will restart it. Nope. If any of the girls die, restart frame 1. Absolutely not. If Dimitri gets bodied, he gets bodied. If the dude gets bodied, he gets bodied. If Sylvain gets bodied, get bodied. If they die, that's fine. Because guess what? Chance is the one who be getting all the girls. They're going to come crying to him. And that's where it starts. That's where it starts, Paul. That's where it starts. But, what else do I have to say? Not really too much to say, but you need Dimitri to beat the game, though? Man, fuck Dimitri. Okay. Screw Dimitri, man. But anyways, thanks for everybody for watching. Jacob, I appreciate the follow. Hopefully, you're in here next time and you're like, you can speak in the chat and say what's up. But yeah. And that's pretty much it. I feel like this game isn't going to be super long. It's 3 houses. Not by a long shot. But... Y'all take care, and I'll catch you on the next Fire Emblem 3 Hopes stream. Also, Paul, let me know where you're at. For sure. Let me know where you're at. Like, what chapter? I imagine you're, like, on chapter 6 or 7. I feel like maybe this game maybe has, like, 10 to something chapters. I don't know. But I'll see when I get there. But all right, guys. Peace.